I'm Mel, this is Leo, and we together are Produce Moon. And Produce Moon are a digital interactive performance company based in Scotland. We bring tech into theatre, and at the centre of our work is digital innovation. And one of the core things we do is we make VR theatre.
We're currently in a very small world at the moment. We're on residency at the Watermill, and we're in this very tiny flat, and we have about a 3-second commute to the tiny rehearsal room we've been in. So our world is literally like 20 square meters at the moment. Yeah. But we're working on a new show that we thought fits very well with the theme, so we thought we'd talk to you about it. It's a piece of VR theatre inspired by Einstein's dreams, which is a book that basically hypothesizes that when Einstein was developing his theory of time, he had dreams every night. And every night there's a different short story, and each short story is a dream in which time works differently. And it kind of tells the story of that world. So we're looking at that. The show flits between what we call TR, theatrical reality. Came up with that this week, we're really pleased about it. So in TR, it's sort of a story of Mel and I's longing for understanding. That's the phrase we come back to. Our longing to understand reality, to understand ourselves, to understand time. And then the audience is invited to dream. And they do that by putting on headsets and watching some dreams in usually, mainly 360 film. And so they have these little snapshots of us, the snapshots of the dreams, and then they sort of wake up and they're back to theatrical reality. And that's the structure of the show.
And so in terms of those, the kind of dreams that audiences will interact with through the 360 films, they're a mixture of dreams that Einstein has kind of had within this narrative, getting closer to this theory of time. And there are also our dreams as well that we've had. And each of these dreams is in many ways, they're its own kind of tiny little world. And it also within that, it's a kind of fully rendered reality where like the rules work differently, or the gravity works differently, or time works differently. And it's really struck us this week how massive and all encompassing and significant all of these different worlds are, like how huge it is if time flowed backwards, and how these 360 films and these fragments, these moments in, are in some ways just they give us this taste of what could be. They give us this opportunity to kind of glimpse in from where we are in our world. We don't have to kind of we don't have to understand the overwhelming reality, but we can get this glimpse, we can get this small look into what that reality might be like. So specifically, the books in the dreams in Einstein's dreams, the text, all explore worlds in which time works slightly differently. So there's one in which there's a center of time, and at the very center of time, time stands still. And as you move out from the center of time, time speeds up. And so what that means is that people kind of travel towards, pilgrimage towards the center of time. So young families bring their babies because they don't want those babies to grow old. They want to kind of hold the earliest years of their baby's life in the kind of center of time. And new couples will travel to kind of hold themselves in an embrace because they don't want to lose those early moments of a new relationship.
And there's another story where time is worshipped like a god. There's this great clock. And it's the only clock in the whole world. There's no alarms, no phones, no anything. There's one clock in the world, and it's in the center of Rome. And at one point in everyone's life, you pilgrimage to the great clock and you stand underneath it and you chant. And for 1 hour, you watch this giant pendulum swing back and forth and count the seconds and minutes go by. And suddenly your life has these increments. But what happens to the people in the world is that they become really sad and quite angry, because it doesn't matter wherever they are in the world, they have this knowledge that somewhere in Rome there is a clock counting down and quantifying their life.
And so alongside these stories, we have made the commitment to record all of our dreams for the next 2 years. And what this looks like is every morning we record each other voice notes while we're kind of still emerging from the depths of sleep, and try and grasp that, try and capture what we dreamt about the night before. And I guess our theory behind this is that hopefully through capturing our dreams, through looking at these dreams, we can discover something new about our reality, maybe as significant as Einstein did.
It is open. So that's what we're working on currently. And it's been so lovely to be here and watch all the talks. And in particular, I guess with this work and our practice in general at the moment, if anyone is interested in these themes or wants to chat, please get in touch. And we're always looking for new collaborators.
Thank you.